So what's a bit? And a bit is the smallest unit of information. So suppose I tell you that there are two boxes. There's a green box and a blue box. And in one of those two boxes, there's a gold star. And it's equally likely to be in either the green box or the blue box. One bit is the answer to one yes or no question. So if you ask one yes or no question, you ask, is the gold star in the green box? Then you get one bit back as the response. You get an answer that's either yes or no. And when you learn which one it is, that's one bit of information that allows you to go from having two choices down to one choice. And then you know, well, if the answer was yes, the gold star is in the green box. That's the one you should open. So when we think about bits in computing, we don't usually call them yes or no. We call them 0 and 1. 0 more readily maps to no and 1 to yes. So I switch blue and green here. But we could pick any two things. We could use green and blue. We could use yes and no. If we have two things and we can choose one of them, knowing which one to choose is one bit of information. So that's what one bit can do. It allows us to decide between two things. For the ancient Greeks network, maybe that's all it could transmit. There was either the no bit, which said there weren't any enemies arriving, or if there was a smoke signal, that was one bit saying, yes, there is an enemy arriving. So it's possible if it was only able to transmit that one message, that it only conveyed one bit of information. If all we can do is send bits, we can send either a 0 or a 1, or a yes or a no, but let's think of it as 0 and 1s now. Can we send anything more interesting? Can we just send one thing? And it turns out that we can actually send everything that we want just using bits. So instead of just picking between two boxes, now let's suppose there were four boxes. So let's say there's a purple box and there's a dark red box. So now there are four boxes. There's still only one gold star. So can we figure out which box the gold star is in with just yes, no questions? Well, one way to do that would be to ask four questions, right? We could say, is it in the green box? We could ask, is it in the purple box? We could ask, is it in the blue box? And as long as we know there's at least one gold star, we don't really need to ask if it's in the dark red box, because if we got no's for all three of these, well, then we know the answer to that next question. If we asked if it was in the red box, would be yes. So here we needed up to three questions to figure out which box the gold star was in. Can we do better? So the question is, how many bits do we need to find the gold star? And remember, each bit is the answer to one yes or no question. And we have four possible boxes, and the gold star could be in any one of those four.